Good morning.
And welcome to Live with Lucky.
Happy Tuesday, January 19th.
It's Tuesday, but it's kind of like a fake Monday because it's our first day of the work week. We had a wonderful holiday yesterday honoring a very special man, Martin Luther King Jr.
Yes.
So I loved reflecting on all he's done for our great nation yesterday. And happy fake Monday/Tuesday.
Yeah. Well, let's get started with our Shamrock Pledge. Ready? Salute. Pledge.
We are the scholars of Shamrock Gardens. We are dedicated, committed, and focused. We prepare for greatness by doing our best every day. We cooperate with our classmates, teachers, and staff. We respect ourselves and all people. We know that hard work is the key to success. There are no limits to how far we can go. We dream big, believe, and achieve. We will graduate from high school and be college and career ready. We will succeed.
Well, today is Tuesday, so it's Health Tips Tuesday. And we actually have a special guest returning today.
She should be
popping in. We're really excited.
There she is. Special guest, Miss Sana Garrett.
Oh, good morning. How are you all?
Hey, doing well. Nice to see you on our show today. How are you?
Thank you for having me. I am doing well. And how are you, Miss Miller?
I'm good. I'm actually just going through one of my favorite possessions, this family cookbook that I received a few years ago from my mom, and it's actually filled with recipes from all my family members. And when I menu plan, we like to try new things, and the reason that I love this so much is because there's a lot of diversity in here. So like, my mom is originally from Puerto Rico, so there's a lot of really great Puerto Rican recipes in here. And then my other side of the family, there's lots of delicious Southern casseroles and just a variety of different foods in here that I like to, pull out and try from time to time. Like my Aunt Susie's potato casserole. There's just all kinds of really a honey bun cake. Just all kinds of great things in here.
Yeah, I
have to put it to the side for now, though, but go ahead.
It's great for Health Tips Tuesday because, you know, a lot of our health tips are like, make sure you're eating healthy, make sure you're, you know, trying to get a variety of foods. And so having a cookbook is a great way to like meet some of those goals, like especially if it's a family cookbook.
It's something like true to your heart. And when we make things that are special to us, it is warming your soul and making you feel so good. And that is healthy in and of itself. And it's so funny that you mentioned that, because at Shamrock, we're actually trying to make a cookbook. And since we are a family, it's almost like we're making our own family cookbook at Shamrock.
Wait, what? A Shamrock cookbook?
Yes.
Teacher
recipes, student recipes. You know, when I think about cooking, I think about my family too. I'm Italian and Puerto Rican. We're eating for everything. Anything special, we're eating. So holidays, birthdays, and there's always special recipes that we have. You know, I remember grandma baking biscotti and all her different Italian cookies for the holidays, and then fun different dinner ideas for picnics and outings. So I really want to do that with our Shamrock family as well. Things that are special to you. So students and staff.
Oh, yeah. I think Miss Sana Garrett even made a slide for this.
Yeah, let me pull that
today.
Up right now. Let's see. Yep, right here it is.
Oh, so tell us, how do we do this, Miss Sana Garrett? This looks amazing.
So we've put links in all of the parent newsletters, and then your teachers will have it as well. And all you have to do is submit your name and grade and then a recipe, and tell us why it's special to you. Do you make it every single year on your birthday? Is it something you always have at a holiday? Is it something cultural? Mm-hmm. You know, for some religious holidays, there's certain foods you might have, mm-hmm. but what makes it special?
Or even, it could even be like something that your great, great, great grandmother made that mm-hmm. like you've been passing down generation after generation, and it's just really special to your family. Let's see what this looks like. Oh, right here is what the form would look like that's in that newsletter, right? So name, grade, recipe, like you said, special, and you can even submit a photo of its deliciousness there. And then what happens? What's the next step?
Yeah, so you just submit it and it will go to me. And once I gather all of those recipes together, I'm gonna compile it and put it into one big recipe book for Shamrock.
Wait, how now, once we get this recipe book, is there gonna be like an option to take the whole recipe book home to your own house? Like, how does that work?
So that's what we're hoping for. We're gonna make an online version, and then we're hoping to make a printed version where everyone will be able to take it home and have their own Shamrock recipe book.
Oh, I'm just so excited. I know I have an idea for a submission already.
Me too.
And I think that you guys will like it if you try it. You'll have another to check question, out the recipe though. Book.
I really love to cook. So are you allowed to put in more? Can you submit more than one recipe? Like if you want to do maybe like an entree and a dessert, or maybe like an appetizer or a favorite little lunch that you like to make?
Absolutely. Send them all in. You can send up to, let's say, up to 3 recipes each. Cool. And that way we'll have options for appetizers, entrees, snacks, desserts, breakfast. Especially in these times, I don't know about you, but all I'm doing is cooking and eating. So it would give me a lot more variety.
I love it.
Well, then I can put that Shamrock cookbook on my shelf beside my family cookbook. And I might be like one night, you know what? I think I'm going to go in here and I'm going to make Miss Sonagera's grandmother's biscotti recipe tonight. And I'm going to make a student's recipe tomorrow.
That'd be so cool. Mm-hmm. That would be so cool. So scholars, just to review, this link is in the newsletter that your parents have access to. Your parents have this newsletter in their email every Friday.
Yeah.
So if you are really excited about a recipe that you want to submit, go run to your parents and say, where's the newsletter? We have to find the link for the recipes.
Yes, yes. Well, I am very excited to see how many scholars submit these recipes with their families. I think this is a fantastic idea, Ms. Sonagera. Thank you so much for coming up with this and leading this for our school so that we can have our first ever Shamrock Gardens family.
Thank you. I'm excited. I'm excited to see all the recipes pop in and see what everyone makes all the time.
Yeah. Ooh. Well, everyone have an awesome day of teaching and learning, and we'll see you tomorrow on Live with Lucky.
Bye.